Now come to the next topic, that is specific heat capacity, that is denoted by C. To understand the specific heat capacity, consider this diagram. Here we have two containers, 1 and 2, having 1 kg and 10 kg water respectively at 10 degrees Celsius. Okay, and we have to raise the temperature of both the waters equally, that is from 10 degrees Celsius to 100 degrees Celsius. Okay, then tell me which container will require more heat? Second one. Okay, because second container has greater mass than that of first one. Okay, so if Q1 heat is supplied to the first container and Q2 heat is supplied to the second container, for the same rise in temperature, Q2 must be greater than Q1. Why? Because mass is greater. So from this discussion, we can conclude that greater the mass, greater must be the heat supplied for the same rise in temperature. So Q is directly proportional to mass for the same rise in temperature. Okay, for the same rise in temperature. Okay, now come to the next diagram. In the diagram, we have two identical containers having equal mass of water, that is 1 kg. But we have to raise the temperature of the first container from 10 degrees Celsius to 50 degrees Celsius. Whereas for the second container, we have to rise the temperature from 10 degrees Celsius to 100 degrees Celsius. Okay, so rise in temperature is different, but the mass is same. Okay, then tell me which container will require more heat. Obviously, the second one, because we have to rise the temperature from 10 to 100. So the rise in temperature is more for the second container than that of first one. So if the heat supplied to the first container is Q1 and to the second container is Q2, then Q2 must be greater than Q1. Okay, so we can conclude from this discussion that the heat supplied is also proportional to the change in temperature. Greater the change in temperature, greater must be the heat supplied for the same mass. Okay, so from these two relations, we can merge them and write Q is directly proportional to M delta T. Okay, we can write this relation by merging these two. Okay, and you know that when you remove the proportionality sign, then you have to insert or introduce a constant. Okay, so Q is equals to C M delta T. Here this C is the specific heat capacity of the material, okay, whose temperature is going to change by supplying heat Q. Okay, so this is the relation. So from this relation Q is equals to Cm delta T, we can rewrite the expression for C, that is C is equals to Q divided by M delta T. Okay, and if M is equals to 1 kg and delta T is equals to 1 degree Celsius, then C is equals to Q. Now we can write the definition of specific heat capacity of a material. That is, the specific heat capacity of a material is the amount of heat required to raise the temperature of the material of mass 1 kg through 1 degree Celsius. Okay, so we can write the specific heat capacity of a material is the amount of heat required to raise the temperature of unit mass of the material, that is 1 kg mass of the material, through 1 degree Celsius. Okay, so this is the specific heat capacity, the definition of specific heat capacity of a material, and the unit is, we can write unit from this expression. The unit of specific heat capacity is the unit of heat, that is joule, divided by unit of mass is kg in SI system, and the unit of temperature is Kelvin. Okay, but one thing is to be noted, that this is the difference in temperature, and difference in temperature is same on Kelvin and Celsius scale. Okay, so if we talk about the difference in temperature, then it would be same on both these scales, Kelvin and Celsius. So we can write Kelvin or joule per kilogram degree Celsius, both are correct. Okay, so note it down. Now let's do this numerical. That is, 15 kilogram of water is to be heated in a geyser from 10 degrees Celsius to 40 degrees Celsius. How much heat is to be supplied to water given the specific heat of water is 4200 joule per kilogram per degree Celsius? Okay, so first of all, write the quantities given in the question. First, the mass of water is given, that is 15 kg, and the temperature difference is given, delta T. Final temperature is 40, initial temperature is 10. So final temperature minus initial temperature is the temperature difference, and that is 30 degrees Celsius. And how much heat is supplied? Q, since Q is equals to Cm delta T, here the material is water, so we write the values of water here. Okay, so the specific heat capacity of water is 4200, mass is 15, and temperature difference is 30. And when you solve these numbers, then you will get 189,000 and joule. Okay, and this can be written as 456, 1.89 into 10 to the power 6 joule. Okay, so this much heat energy is supplied to the water for this rise in temperature from 10 to 40 degrees Celsius.